Hey everyone, Myra here with Somatic Therapy Partners. I wanted to spend a little time and talk to you about the five channels of the body. This is a somatic experiencing concept. So for those of you that are interested in somatic, based approaches to therapy, this is a great video for you to watch. So one of the things that we learn in somatic experiencing when we are trying to help clients become more embodied, meaning to be able to be more connected to their body and more attuned to what's happening in their body. And we use this acronym called SIBAM. SIBAM S stands for the somatics of a situation, and I'll go through all of this here momentarily. I stands for imagery, B stands for behavior, A stands for affect, and M stands for meaning. Now, the most important thing that I want you to get from this video is that when we're dealing with somatic approaches to wellness and to healing from trauma and anxiety, we have to learn how to listen to our body. And so these five channels that I just named for you are the five things that we as clinicians are looking for with our clients when we're in session with them, and we want to help them expand. Most of my clients come in with really strong meaning making, which just basically means that a lot of the clients that I work with are really good at thinking and being in their head and intellectualizing. And my job as a somatic experiencing practitioner is to help create more of a connection between mind and body so that instead of the mind always talking to the body always also has an opportunity to talk to the mind. So when we're talking about SIBAM, ways that you can work with this are practicing. So we'll go through each of the channels. So S stands for somatics, and somatics means anything related to the body. So something I often do with clients is when they're sharing a thought with me, so they might say something like, "Yeah, my dad was late again and it was really upsetting for me." And I will ask them to notice, and what's happening in your body when you think of that thought that your dad was running late again? And what I'll invite clients to do is to notice sensations. I'll have them notice impulses. I'll have them notice any kind of physical changes to their posture or to the way that they're breathing. So somatics basically encompasses everything related to what's happening in the body. So that's one of the channels. The second channel that we also try to help clients expand into is imagery, right? And so one of the interesting things about working with imagery I've noticed in working with clients is that really amazing natural organic imagery starts to rise up as clients become more connected to their body, and they don't have to look for information. We're very mind-based. We're always looking for information, typically outside there, not always inside here. So imagery is one of those things that often happens in sessions, but it can also just happen when you're somatically tracking yourself or just noticing what's happening in your body. So we look for the channel for imagery. B stands for behavior. So what is it that you're actually doing in response to that thought? So with this same example, the client that I'm thinking of, she was talking about her father. And anytime she started talking about her father for any length of time, she just naturally started to get more fidgety. She would sit in her chair and she'd just kind of move around a lot. And I would support this client by helping her spend time noticing that her energy levels in terms of her fidgetiness were starting to go up. So that's behavior. Anything related to what's happening for you that gets translated into an action that you take. So that's the B of SIBAM. A stands for affect. Affect is just a fancy word for emotions. And so in this same incident, one of the things that we realized is that as this client was talking about her dad, she was actually feeling a lot of grief, right? And so not only would she get fidgety because she didn't know how to deal with her grief, but she'd also get fidgety as a way of sort of getting away from that grief that she was experiencing in her body. So a lot of times I'm working with clients, just helping them to identify what their emotions are and what happens in their body as that emotion comes on. And then the last piece is M for meaning making. So those are the five channels. And the thing I want you to get the most from this video is for you to choose one or two other channels that maybe you are not as adept with, right? So I said earlier in the video, most of my clients come in with really strong meaning making, meaning they're really good at thinking and trying to figure things out. Not so good as at the S part of the SIBAM of the five channels of the body. And so I spend a lot of time helping them feel into and sense into their body. So for you, the watcher, I encourage you to identify what might be one or two of SIBAM that you tend to use a lot of. Most of you watching will probably fall into that category where you do a lot of meaning making, but maybe not any of the other channels. So if that's you, then I invite you to find one or two of these other channels, and the channels again are somatics, imagery, behavior, affect, and meaning making, and practice noticing those other aspects of your experience besides just your thoughts, right? So for somatics, you would just notice what's happening in your body. With eye, you would just notice any kind of imagery. Related to imagery is also memory. Memory is something that shows up with clients a lot. And then when you're having an experience, what are the things that your body is doing and really becoming aware that maybe you're becoming fidgety or you're starting to sort of implode in on yourself and sort of go into this collapse posture. You're just looking for anything related to that. And then A stands for affect, again, meaning what are you feeling? And then the meaning making are the thoughts that you're using. So that's a little lesson here in how we do somatic experiencing using this particular tool called Cyban. Thank you so much for watching. I really look forward to seeing you in future videos. And there is so much love for you here at Somatic Therapy Partners.